morning.
How's it been?
Oh, well, thank God.
What was going on in the agency?
Well, they just we have a lot of activities going on in the agency, and what we've done in the last 8 months is to ensure that we set we have a template that will guarantee the sustainable growth in the agency.
Okay.
And so.
All right, then, no problem. We have lots of issues for you this morning, but first off, let's even quickly bring the attention of. I'm sure that EY Nigeria must have taken note. You brought the attention of this house to, you know, the death around. I mean, the refuse bin and all of that. It looks like the refuse trailer trucks, or probably I don't know, maybe more like the iron bins have been taken out of those strategic points.
Yeah.
So the question is, where would people dump their refuse, especially when you don't have a car and you have briefings about what's happening in its agency? But before then, don't forget about, talking about the microfinance agency, Nikiti. It looks like you are out with the big box for the people.
Yeah. Well, like I said earlier on, the agency is actually out the instruction of Mr. Governor to ensure that we change the phase of economic activity in the state. What we've seen in the past is that it has been unlucky, like other states. We'll be accessing funds from the Bank of Industry, Bank of Agric, or even CBN. But what has been happening? This money has been going to wrong hand, and people have just been taking money, and the thinking was that any money that is coming through government is a free fund, and that it's a grant that we're going to get the money. You can spend it the way you like. But when we came on board, the first thing we did was to ensure that we sensitized, we alerted people that any money we are getting through government in form of loan is not free money. And that
some people take loan and then they do not return it. Yeah. And the government make efforts to get this money back.
No, that one is even another. We're looking at how we can do that and get that money back.
Okay.
So the first thing we did last year was to ensure that we instill financial discipline in people through our reoriented them. There must be a paradigm shift from what used to happen before that. Anything that is coming from government is not free. I mean, that is, it's not just this money and walk away. But what we want to do in this, what we'll be trying to do in the agency is to say, okay, fine, in the past, any all the funds you'll be getting from through government is that we think it's maybe a grant. And so a lot of people just take this loan, but maybe agri-related loan, they will take it and we use to build houses. Some of them will use the money to send their children to school. Fine, they may repay back, no problem. But the primary objective of that money, of that loan, has been defeated. That is, we want to galvanize economic activity in the state.
But when and how do you galvanize? What do you do with the money?
What do you do with the money? Get all this money, maybe give it to peasants, to artisans, or maybe at a...
Strictly for business. Is it strictly for business?
Strictly for business.
Not to buy a car, not to buy a house.
There are different ways of getting loan. Because it's either for transactional purposes, or maybe for speculative purposes, or for precautionary purposes. But you get money, what to invest in your businesses. You have to ensure that you put this money in your businesses. Any income you get on this money, you pay back, maybe like your margin. Pay back the interest of the loan, pay part of the past capital, then the investable fund, the save, you can save. Or you cannot decide to use that one to build your house or maybe to sell your water school. But what we do is any money. And why we have to use it is predominantly it is more of a civil service state. So most of this, so at least everything that happens in the state revolves around any money that is coming from the federal state and the little idea we're able to generate in the state. So all of us are looking towards one direction in the state, that is money coming from federal government. So it is difficult for even for the entrepreneur in the state to access funds.
So has there been a change? I mean, in the last 6 months or
yes, that what I'm coming to. So what we have done in the last 8 months was to let people know, hey, we are good. Mr. Governor had tried for us. He had opened a lot of bits avenues for us to get funds. We're going to get money from USAID funds. We're going to get MSME funds. We're going to get money from AgMES. We're going to get even the almost of the financial institutions that have lost faith in the Kiti State. They're trying to come back because people have been taking money from all these institutions will not be coming back. But we sat down with them. We said, fine, we had a problem in the past. We had monitoring problem. We have not been monitoring this loan. But what we'll be doing now is that okay, we have a template whereby we'll be able to monitor what happens across the system local government. We have a field officer, it's not the system local government now. So we are taking all the loan that we've taken in the past from 2008. We've actually put everything together. We've seen the ones that are recoverable. We've seen the ones that are not recoverable. so we start working on how to get this money back.
In the case where people get loans and do not pay back, what the government do to those people?
Well, you see, that is where we have a problem. The government is a little bit at maybe because there's more of a reputational risk when somebody takes the loan through government and they're not paying back. And when you start chasing them to pay back, they start saying, "Hey, what you do?" And we just and what we're here. You want us to go and call about the government too? They're making that difficult for us. So government will be able to
blackmail you.
Yeah, blackmail you. Okay, this money you can't get this money back. But what we've done, we'll be using more moral suasion to talk to people. That fine. All this money for us, like I said, we were 4.6 billion that day. 4.6 billion since 2008 to do it.
Out in public.
That we are trying to recoup. And when we came aboard, we saw that most of these funds, there's no political will to share this loan, the debt out there. What we did was to call all these people that come. All these funds you have taken that are not paying back is affecting the state because all these financial institutions are not ready to give us more money because we are not paying on what they given us before. So what we did was, okay, we spoke to most of this.
So as a matter of fact, it's not even free money for the government.
This is not free money. For example, all this fund, government is paying back. Because government can get this money, before we can get the money to give to our maybe to citizens, we must have signed an ISPO.
Yeah.
That is okay if these people fail to pay. The state government is guaranteed to pay this money back. And when JKF was living maybe towards the end of 2000, maybe his first tenure, he got a 2 billion facility for the state, MSME fund. And this fund was supposed to be given to the micro and other SME in the SME space. This fund came. And before you know what's happened, unfortunately for Ekiti State, the money came when JKF left. So as the money was, 1.5 billion came from the money, it was administered without proper monitoring. So when we came on board, we have to start calling all these beneficiaries. And someone say, nobody have been calling us to pay this money back. And even someone said, when they told us we collected this money, they didn't give us money that we are going to pay back. Then we'd ask questions. And the first thing that we noticed was, even the administration of this loan was faulty. Because to me, when you are borrowing money from financial institutions, you borrow based on financial needs.
Mm.
If, for example, that's where you see people, they need 2 million for their businesses. And they ask you to write a business plan. The business plan shows that, okay, you need 1.7 billion to do your business. Then at the end of the day, somebody came to you and said, okay, take another 800,000. From the one, what I knew about business lending is that you don't underfund the business.
Oh.
Neither do you overfund the business.
Yeah.
You don't underfund the business, you have prepared that business to fail. Yeah. So what we've seen is that we saw a situation whereby the past administration said that, okay, give these people a flat rate. Either not minding their businesses, they just give everybody across body 80,000 naira.
Mm.
Even somebody that requested for
money. And that will not do much.
They just pocketed the money and said, okay, thank God, because they wasted money to write business plan, they wasted money to collect form, they'll be coming and going back and forth.
And there will be no hope to recover that 80,000 naira.
Absolutely. Mm. So now what we now did was, okay, what we want to do is we want to ensure that any money we are getting out is going to be based on financial needs. So that's what brought us to you of what happened after the, like I said, we've done the mapping and of the entrepreneur in the state. So we know their needs. So that's what now brought us to you of how can we now assess for everybody in the state. So then we have Mr. Governor said, okay, don't worry, we assist. But the first thing is that we must know who and who we are talking with too. Because like I said, in the past, funds are becoming is that we go to the wrong hands. It will not be affecting our economy. Because all the entrepreneurs...
So there's the HMS's training.
I'm coming. Yes.
Because of time.
Yeah. Okay, so now there's a training that we package. We call it the ACMET training. That for agri business for small and medium scale development scheme. And this scheme is an individual thing between you and CBN. And what does that mean? That, okay, you have a business. You don't have money to do your business. Then you are pro-CBN. That, okay, I want to do a business. Then the next thing CBN will say that, okay, go through EDI, that is Enterprise Development Institute. Those people will train you. Initially, it used to be for 3 weeks. Then you pay for the training. After the training, you get your certificate. After the certificate, you get your business plan together. Then you upload and send to CBN. The CBN will now start to follow up with you and give you this facility. But what Mr. Gono said, okay, I want to ensure that people in the state benefit from this scheme. And for information, this is the first time in the history of Nigeria that a state government will package this kind of a scheme together. So Mr. Gondo asked us to train as many as possible. But you can't just make the figure out, you have to have a specific number. So the first thing was that we want to train 4,500 participants for this training, Agnes training. And so we have to tear into two. So the first one was, so we trained 2005. So that was in November, we trained 2005. And this 2005, our thing is that we want to have a vehicle to drive any activity in the state. And what that means is that all these 2005 that we've trained, they were now EDI certified. Mind you, if you are EDI certified, you can take loan from CBN or any CBN related loan. So when we started the training, we know that everybody in the state before think that anyone that is coming is grand. For example, we had 10 centers during the training. I got to a center, one of the guys would say, maybe the guy doesn't even recognize the player. Yugoslavia, yeah.
So,
that we had before. That okay. Then we were packaging this scheme. The scheme was conceptualized by Bureau of Employment Labor Productivity. So when we sat down, we said, okay, this scheme, everybody in the state, we have to instill financial discipline in these people, and there should be a dynamics for this scheme. Because mind you, this agments, this is the first time a state government or any corporate body is bringing together this quantum of numbers. So we brought 2005. Can agments take care of all these people? No. So what do you use this one as a vehicle to drive learning activity in the state?
Wow. Thank you very much, Otumba Akayode. I'm sure that we'll have more time to discuss this because we still have so many other things to discuss on general issues. Alright, don't forget that we'll still talk about, before we start taking your calls, don't forget the phone line is open 0814-441-9455. What Otumba Fasa is saying is there's a plan to ensure that a lot of our UT and Ekiti and business owners have access to loans given by government. And of course, there is going to be a process that you have to follow. It's not business as usual where you take money and then you just abscond, and that's the end of it. And at the end of the day, you will come back to blackmail the government, say, okay, I've gotten my own share of the national cake, there's no way I can return this. Ajemonumini.
So, on the last note, sorry, I want to ask something. In the next 2 weeks, we'll be disbursing loan to our women, the microcredit lending. We have the MSME.
The state government.
Yes, we started that. We do the profiling. We profile about 300 people, 1,000 people. But we started with 300, and this 300, we are taking them away from this lapo women of this world, because you know this are
traders. Where they pay debt
for
life.
Pay, yes. So we are not chasing lapo all of them out of the state, but we want to make it competitive, because you have alternative. It's better for you to go to that, and you have a choice to either choose from going to Lapo or you come to the state government to get a loan. And all those people that have gone through this agreement training, I can show you that Mr. Gono has made provision for all of them.
All right, quickly, Fisayo and Co. PDP protest in Abuja.